identify.
Fair share of the views. Singing words gonna vent our frustration. If we don't, we're gonna blow a 50-amp fuse.
Sing it to me.
So hello YouTube, that was just some footage of some shield abuse that I ran into when I was playing a headquarters match yesterday, and yeah, and unfortunately that type of shield abuse isn't quite common, although there are some noobs who hate on you just because you're getting your streaks and they can't barely get a UAV. So okay, so here in the gameplay here, it's headquarters match, me and Zombie Killer are camping in the back of the map, as you may have noticed, and we're both using target finder LMGs, and we're both using shields, so we prove quite difficult to stop. Honestly, we get whole teams just rushing at us, like, and they can't do anything about us, and I only take one death this gameplay, because these guys are bad. Look, try to jump shot me, really? Really, you think you're gonna take me out? I don't think so. Anyway, fortunately these noobs are pretty stupid, but sometimes it feels like I'm fighting my own teammates more than I'm fighting the enemy. And that's exactly what the shield thinks too, because you saw that shield footage. I mean, that's pretty. Viewer discretion is advised, people. That shield footage wasn't pretty. So, anyway, here. Yeah, these noobs just keep rushing at me. I don't even get why they even bother trying. They're just terrible. Okay, and then Zombie Killer's gone, so, like, I'm all alone here. Oh, yep, there he is. He tries to jump shot me, and then I get a free headshot on him. Okay, cool.
Be advised, hostiles have destroyed the headquarters.
Hey guys, as you'll notice throughout this gameplay, we win by a landslide, even though me and Zombie aren't doing anything to secure the objective at all. So it's basically 4v6, and these randoms pull off the win, and they don't just barely win, they win by like a ton. So, gotta give you some credit, some randoms, you guys aren't as bad as normal randoms are. Probably call you super randoms. I mean, it's a new category of randoms who can actually do stuff. But anyway, good job. Anyway, shout out to the randoms who made this part of this gameplay possible. So you may ask, why are me and Zombie Killer sitting back here instead of like camping the house? It's because the spawns in headquarters are terrible. They're the worst spawns I've seen. Like almost worse than ghosts. Almost worse than ghost spawns. See, those randoms are just wondering what we're doing. But no, we aren't doing anything bad. We're helping you. It's like I use the shield. The shield gets me streaks. So don't knife the shield that feeds you. And as you'll see later on in this game, they do knife the shield that feeds them. It's pretty pathetic. It's pathetic, but they still do. So anyway, I'm just camping back here. And look, and then I decide, like, okay, we've got them pretty good back there, over there, and it's like, no, look, that guy spawned right behind me. Did you see that, guys? That's why headquarters is a pretty bad game mode, or all-around game mode. I don't like it, because it spawns like that. Spawns are terrible. They flip all the time. They're not predictable. Okay, that's not a good thing for a Call of Duty game. If every single game mode had spawns as bad as you know, headquarters, or maybe you never played headquarters, as bad as Call of Duty Ghosts, would you continue to play Call of Duty? Probably not, because you're gonna get killed off streaks, and I know I've been killed off a ton of streaks by deaths like that, or that wasn't really a death, but it could have been, it very well could have been a death, especially like what that guy was using, like a Remington or something. That very well could have been a death. But these guys are just terrible. Just terrible. They actually try to rush us, which is surprising. Well, not surprising. I mean, given that, if you take into consideration the fact that noobs only have half a brain, then you'll start understanding why they keep trying to rush us. Because to fully understand noobs, you need to think like a noob. If a noob sees a camper camping at the back of the map, what's the first thing they're going to do? They're going to be like, oh, I'm going to kill that camper no matter how many deaths it takes. And Guys, that's not the mindset or the mentality you want to go into Call of Duty with, because if you do that, I can almost guarantee you, you will have a negative KD. And that's what most randoms have. They play the objective all the time, and a lot of times they don't even have a positive win-loss, so... Hey, yay, randoms, going for the win. Great job, randoms. Great job. So anyway, guys, look, we're just owning the other team in terms of score, but not like the score matters. I mean, does win-loss really matter? Probably not. Most Call of Duty players probably doesn't. Because those are the thing that separates Call of Duty from other games like Battlefield. It's like those killstreaks. If you took out the killstreaks, Call of Duty wouldn't be Call of Duty. Call of Duty pretty much Battlefield. So with that in mind, they'll always be camping Call of Duty, guys. And look, these guys don't understand it. They're like, no, you're supposed to be playing the objective. No. Get out of the spawn. Get out of the spawn. It's like, no, I don't care that you're getting me V-Stats. I don't care that you're getting me VTOLs. I don't care that you're getting me dogs. I don't care that you're helping us win the game. But get out of the spawn and do something. That's it from the narrow mind of a noob. Look, we're all three of us, like the people who are doing well on our team. That's me, Zombie, and this other random who's actually doing really well. It's just surprisingly with no shields. And he's doing well. And it's like, okay. You just sit, we're just teabagging there because, you know, a lot of times, like, after you kill all the enemies and you're just waiting for the headquarters to be destroyed, there's really not much to do. There's really not. So what these randoms don't understand is that getting high streaks is going to help you win the game. And I mean, part of the reason we probably won by such a large amount was the streaks that we hauled in. Headquarters captured. So guys, camping for streaks is beneficial to your team in most circumstances. So if you guys don't already do that, definitely give that a try.
Friendly hunter killer drone deployed.
Oh, hey guys, before I forget, I'd also like to thank you guys for all your support and everything, because today I reached 700 subscribers, so thank you for that. Thank you all for that, and it's been on YouTube for less than 3 months, and I'm pretty pleased with the growth of my channel, so yeah, I'm pretty impressed. Yeah, thanks you guys for all your support, and just keep up the good work. By the way, guys, we have less than 3 days until Advanced Warfare comes out. A little over 48 hours, I believe, until the midnight release, or I think some midnight release thing for Day Zero, but definitely not gonna be getting it then. I'm gonna be getting it like Monday afternoon or something. But anyway, guys, speaking of Advanced Warfare, the six-man thing, like, by the time this video goes up, it'll probably be the six-man thing. I'll probably close it off, and I'll start making my list, and it's like, and deciding who's gonna be my six-man. So, yeah, guys, I'll have that as soon as possible. Look forward to playing with Advanced Warfare, you guys. It'll be pretty fun. I mean, the shield's making a return, killstreaks, powerful killstreaks coming back. So pretty much everything you could want in a Call of Duty game. Sure, it may not be a flawless Call of Duty, but it's probably going to be the most fun. No, don't believe me, just look at the trailer, look at everything we've got so far. I mean, they're bringing back everything a camper or prep stomper would want. And plus, guys, I just found out today that Zombies, the game mode, there's a fourth game mode, Zombies, is coming back. It was confirmed by a leaked trailer that was leaked on the internet, and developers even confirmed that too, because they were kind of like disappointed that the trailer got leaked, but that's kind of expected given that people get the game early and in retail stores break the release date sort of thing. So it's kind of expected that something like this would be leaked, but I had a feeling they had something like this up their sleeves, because if they developed this game for 3 years and they didn't have any fourth game mode or something extra other than campaign and multiplayer and that survival mode, then it might have been disappointing. But I think they're listening to the fan base, and they're actually bringing stuff that we as players want, and that's a good thing, guys. I mean, I like Zombies. I mean, sure, not as much as multiplayer, so I don't really play too many Zombies these days, just because all the maps on Black Ops 2 are at least a year old. Black Ops 2 is a game itself is almost 2 years old, so after playing those maps for a while, I'm kind of getting bored of them, and getting kind of bored of BO2 multiplayer to some degree. So just happy Advanced Warfare is going to come out in a few days and time, and yeah, get to play that with you guys and start this Shield Revolution of 2054, because You know the 2025 one's already begun, but it'll be interesting to see how the 2054 one pans out. Really want to see that one. I want to see how the game mechanics work. Of course, I won't be in the EXO playlist. Probably won't even give that a chance because I don't feel like learning all the movements, and I don't like how it gives tools to rushers to get rid of campers. I don't like that. So you'll probably see me in the no EXO playlist pretty much all the time. So anyway, guys, this gameplay is just coming to an end here. Look how we just smack these noobs. Look at the score, guys. These guys didn't have a chance, so. Anyway, guys, that's the gameplay. Don't forget to like, subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, thanks for watching. This has been World of Warbuckets Pro, and thanks for 700 subscribers, guys. Just thanks so much. And now, guys, let's go to who this video is really dedicated for. To the Shield. The Shield won't be missed. It'll be in Advanced Warfare, so look forward to that.